Now, anyone who reads Sasha Rodoy's website, Optical Express, Ruined My Life, will probably think that they know exactly what it's about, but this story isn't as straightforward as it seems. The website is one of a growing number of what are called gripe sites set up by people who want to campaign against particular companies and do it online. Anyone who searches for her corresponding Facebook page won't be able to find it, because Facebook was asked to take it down by Optical Express, who said it was defamatory, and Facebook did that without speaking to Sasha first.
I launched my websites after suffering debilitating side effects from my own laser eye surgery. Now I'm fighting for government legislation, and that's what I do. I'm determined to stop this industry from damaging any more people's eyes.
So what's wrong with your own sight now?
Before I had eye surgery, I was short-sighted. I only needed glasses for distance. After surgery, I'm now nearly 4 years post-op, not only did I suffer side effects like starburst, which means I can't drive at night, loss of depth perception, a loss of vision in low light, dry eyes, halos, and now I need 3 prescriptions.
It wasn't Optical Express, though, who did your surgery.
Indeed, it wasn't, and I'm not allowed to talk about the company who operated on my eyes, because when people have an out-of-court settlement, they generally sign a gagging order. Therefore, I am restricted. However, if you put my name into Google or YouTube, what I can't say, other people can.
What are you trying to do with the website?
The website is to alert people who are considering surgery to do their research, and I'm also trying to help as many people as I can who are damaged.
The websites are still on the internet. Why is that?
The website Optical Express Ruined My Life was challenged by Optical Express 3 times. Their complaints were made to Nominet, who is the registrant for all domain names. And if there's any dispute, you make a complaint to Nominet. 5 independent expert solicitors agreed across 2 years that my site was a valid gripe site, for want of a better term, and it was serving the purpose I claimed it was.
But Facebook took your campaign page down. Why was that?
After 2.5 years, Optical Express put in a complaint saying that the content was defamatory. Now, Facebook just took it down without any discussion with me, no due diligence, and no option for me to challenge this.
I'm assuming you've contacted Facebook. What did they say?
They told me it was because of defamatory content reported by Optical Express. Now, there has never been any litigation against me, and I believe that Facebook should have checked whether or not there was any case against me for libel or defamation or anything else. There is none. Therefore, Facebook should put my page back up.
Well, that was Sasha Rodoy, and we spoke to Facebook. They told us they don't comment when they make decisions like this, but they directed us to their terms and conditions, which say pages must not contain false, misleading, fraudulent or deceptive claims or content. Optical Express told us
employers have a duty of care to protect their employees from receiving upsetting and inappropriate personalised communications at work. And a number of Optical Express employees have contacted Facebook, the Information Commissioner's Office and police regarding unacceptable online communications received by or referring to them, including via the social media channels in question. This included photos and videos of them taken and posted without their consent, a photograph of the head of a slaughtered pig, insults, false allegations, and the posting of personal details, such as their telephone numbers and a link to their home address. Some staff have taken leave of absence due to the distress caused by these incidents. No one should be subject to this type of invasion of privacy when going about their job.
Well, Optical Express gave us that statement only a few minutes before we came on air, although we have been speaking to them for several days now, and we were unable to contact Sasha Rodoy again. But we do have a lawyer with us here. He's Steve Kuncevich. He's a media lawyer, and he's represented people in disputes over these gripe sites. Steve, Sasha's unhappy Facebook took down the page without consulting her. Does it surprise you that Facebook did this when as she says, no one has been able to make her take down the website.
Well, no, not particularly. I mean, mainly because Facebook now is in a very different position as it was a few years ago, in that it's a publicly traded company. It's had to grow up in public, and it has had a number of very interesting incidents happen where abuse has been reported, not followed up properly, where they've been asked to put systems in place and maybe haven't followed it. So you've got to remember that there's the law, and then there's Facebook's own content guidelines. Very often they'll go off their own content guidelines, and if they're not happy with something, then they will take it down to avoid any claim being made against them as much as the person who's posting the content up in the first place. The way the law works now, they're actually quite heavily protected if they do that, if they take down first and ask questions later. So if they don't have an editorial agenda, if they're not, say, newspaper, then they may view this kind of thing very differently.
Well, Sasha's named Optical Express in the title of her gripe site, even though it didn't provide her treatment. Is that fair?
I think that's a very fair question. I think if you were asking the question of the press as to whether or not they should report certain things, or should put certain headlines on to get people to click on a page, and then it turns out that the story doesn't bear any resemblance to that, then that's a very valid debate to be had. The issue is that a lot of people who set up these gripe sites now are very savvy, know how to work around search engine optimization in its basic form, know how to get their sites up to the top of the page because it's updated very regularly with new content. If someone does have a genuine gripe, they'll write about it an awful lot, so there's no shortage of new stuff to go on there. I do think it's a fair question to be asked, and it's a debate to be had, in that we've seen an awful lot of movement from people like the Justice Secretary, where we're talking about how we deal with personal attacks online. As much as free speech should be protected, and it absolutely should be, where is the company's remedy in all of this? Because of the changes to libel law recently make it much more difficult for a corporate claimant to bring a claim. And more often than not, from a public perception point of view, if they look to bring this kind of claim, they're only adding the oxygen of publicity to the allegations in the first place. So it's a no-win situation to a degree. But if I'm the company and reputation is at the top of my list of risks, and I owe a duty of care to protect my employees, I may be forced to take action.